Hi everyone, welcome back to Tech DIY. So in today's playground session, we are going to see producer consumer with Kafka, Kafka configurations. Watch out for some changes which have happened with the newest Spring library, Spring Kafka library. So with that, let's get started. So what dependencies we are going to have are Lombok, Spring Kafka and Spring Web. So here we are starting Zookeeper, and Kafka is already installed in our machine. So we are going to start Zookeeper first, then we are going to start the Kafka server. So as you all know, Zookeeper would be listening at port number 2181 and Kafka server would be listening at port number 9092. So here we are starting the Kafka server and Zookeeper. So the Kafka server commands, as you can see on your on the left side of the screen, and we are just creating one topic on the terminal window. And in this session, actually for making this session, we have faced a lot of issues also. So while covering the consumer part, there are some changes which need to be done in the new consumer Kafka consumer configuration. So we will cover that as well, and how we resolve those issues, we will cover that also in that part. So here we are simply creating one topic, and we will creating the topic with defaults, Kafka topic with defaults, and here we are importing the project into our IDEA, and now it's loading the project. Once it loads, we will have a model, packages as model, configuration, and the POM, as you can see the dependencies which we have added. And now package, we will have model, we will have controller, and we will have config. So in model, we are adding the Lombok annotations like data, all our constructor, no our constructor, SLF4j also. Ideally SLF4j, since it is a model class, so it's not needed much. ToString we have added there, and then we are writing the configuration for this. So messaging, we are giving the name as messaging configuration, and here we need to add the configuration properties as well as bin, as well as so since it is a producer, so we need to add the producer factory. Okay, and then we will create the producer configurations also here. So that producer factory will be consuming them. So we are adding them as a hash map. So in this config hash map, we are using producer config. It's a constant class which gives all the constants related to common properties which need to be set up for producers. So that we are doing here. And as I mentioned earlier, so server is listening at 9092. So that we have created as a static constant in our messaging configuration file, named as Bootstrap, and then we are setting the common configurations. So Bootstrap server config we have added, then key serializer config we have added, and now we are adding JSON serializer. And that's pretty much about the producer. So producer factory, we have passed config hash map into that, and the next thing is we need to add the bin for Kafka template. And for this Kafka template, we have created that, and that's it. That's the configuration for producer. We are correcting the name of the class also, and then we are going to have a constant for topic name. So we are giving topic, whatever topic we created there in the server, in the Kafka server. So now we are creating the controller. This controller is a simple controller, simple REST controller, which is where we are just passing the message as message ID, and producer slash message ID, and then we will pass message into that. And it's a simple GET mapping. So what we are doing here, we are simply from our browser we will test it. So we will simply pass the message, so that message object should go to, you know, Kafka and Kafka topic, and that should be read from the consumers. Once it is, producer will put the message there and consumer will read from there. So that's what we are going to do. Similar kind of thing we have done for RabbitMQ in our previous video. The link will be available as on the right top corner for that. So you can refer that also for RabbitMQ. Here we are doing for Kafka. And we are Kafka.send, Kafka template.send method is basically the one which we will be using. So we need to mention the topic and we need to pass the object which we want to send. In this case, we are sending the message. So message and topic name and the message we have passed. And here what we are going to do is, we are going to add a console consumer. So whatever we will be placing in the producer, message we are placing in the producer, that should go and should be shown in the console consumer. So we have started the console consumer. Let's start the producer. Yeah, so server is started. And let's give it a try. So we are going to give a message here. Simply we will say 8080 slash the message ID, and we are going to give the message ID. So we have given the long, so it should be long only, but by mistake we have given the string, so we are going to correct it. Instead of that, we are passing 1L or 1. So okay, we need to give only 1, so that as an ID. And yeah, now it is showing. So subscribe now is the message, so follow the message and subscribe our channel. And now we are going to create another, we are going to create Kafka consumer. So the one which we have seen is console consumer, and now we are going to create our own consumer. Okay, so the same configurations, same Lombok and web and Spring Kafka we are going to use here. And our version is Spring Kafka is above 2.0. so about 2.0 there are several issues which started coming. Earlier it was very straightforward configuration, but we will see them once they will come up. So now initially we are going to do as the previous, as per the normal way of configuring the consumer. So same message we have, message object we have created under our model package here in the consumer. And now we need to do for consumers, we need to add this at enable Kafka annotation. So we have done that at the class level, so that enables the auto configuration for Kafka consumer. And now we are copying the bootstrap related properties and employee topic, the message topic from the producer. And here again in consumer also we need to configure the consumer factory bean that we are doing here again as we have done earlier in the producer. But here few things would be different. Bootstrap server would definitely be same, and then key deserializer we would be using same way, value deserializer we should be using. And then apart from that, we need to pass the group ID, topic group ID, so that we are going to add here. And that's pretty much of it. And we need to pass that map into new default Kafka consumer factory. And now we are going to create concurrent Kafka listener container factory. These two beans we need to add for our Kafka consumers, Kafka consumer code. So that's what we are going to do. So this class have these many methods. So you can refer that class on net. You can see the details of that concurrent Kafka listener. So yeah. So here for concurrent Kafka listener, we are simply naming it as Kafka listener container factory, and we are creating one concurrent Kafka listener container factory with string and message type. And that's it. We have set our consumer factory bean injected here, and now we are done with that. And one more thing is with Spring Kafka 2.0 and above, we need to provide the trusted package also. So the configuration is basically JSON deserializer class is there, so at we need to pass that JSON deserializer and trusted package. In trusted package we need to mention the message class package name. So in our case the context main context is message, so we are adding that. Now we are writing the controller, consumer controller. So what we are going to do is slash consumer get mapping we are providing. So when we do slash consumer, what it should do is basically it should load this message from Kafka, one class level variable we have added. So whenever the it will listen from Kafka listener, so this variable value, this field value will update, and whenever we hit, but this whole operation is asynchronous. So whenever we will hit the consumer slash consumer, it will load the last value, last read value from the Kafka topic. So that's what it's going to do. And the Kafka listener, yes, add Kafka listener is the annotation we need to add here. So we have added that, and topics is the attribute we need to provide there. And since 8080 producer is running, so we have added 8081. Yeah, and I think that's pretty much of it. So we are logging also with SLF4j annotation. So just we are going to give a bouncing the server. Let's see what happens with this. Now we are hitting that again for consumer. So nothing is happening. Let's see. Oh, we forgot to mention the group ID. So we are copy pasting that group ID again there at the listener. So we are pasting that at the listener and bouncing the server again. Seems we got some exception, so we are going. So we are going to redo that message, re-put from producer. So that is put, but listener is not working. Let's see why it's not working. There seems to be some issue or some problem. Let's see what the problem is. So in producer, okay. In consumer, as we can see, the in consumer it is showing that serialization exception. Okay. So this serialization exception, we need to check on the net. Actually, what message it is showing? This error handler cannot process serialization exception directly, please. Okay, so the problem here is since Kafka producer, while sending the message, they have taken the metadata also. So the model of producer package, I mean the path of producer package is different than path of consumer package. That obviously would be there. So this error started coming after that. So now they are telling about that producer dot model is not compatible. Obviously it won't be. So we searched on the net. We searched on many threads for this particular issue, and we identified this particular link. We will share this link on the description section, and we are going to change our configuration as per this particular link, and we are going to try our consumer again. So this configuration, what it says is JSON deserializer, we need to manually add some configurations into JSON deserializer, and that JSON deserializer we need to pass in the config, in the value config, and then in the while creating the Kafka consumer factory also we need to pass that. So that we are going to do now. And for coming out of this error or resolving this error, we tried to modify some configurations in producer also, like enabling, disabling the add headers, but that also won't work, so we will change that later. So now we are going to add the JSON deserializer as per that suggested in that Stack Overflow thread, and we are creating the deserializer here, and we'll add the defaults, I mean whatever needed or suggested there. So deserialize, we need to deserialize message class of our consumer package, consumer model package, and deserialize add trusted packages. So we are saying trust on all packages, and then we are saying remove type header. So we are trying to get whatever they have suggested, we are trying to do that. So we are saying use type headers, so use type mappers, I think use type header for key, type mapper for key, yeah, this one they are suggesting. So in this we need to say yes, true for this. Deserializer, I think set type, remove type header also we need to enable, so we are enabling that. So with these deserializer configurations, ultimately remove type header we are saying false, and type mapper we are saying true, and then deserializer we need to configure here. Instead of custom JSON deserializer, we need to pass our deserializer object, which we have just now created. And in default consumer Kafka also, we need to call the different version where we need to pass the key serializer is string deserializer and values serializer is deserializer, our object, newly created object. So that is what we are going to do. And change we need to do there in consumer is apart from that. Okay, in Kafka listener also they are suggesting at Kafka listener we need to make some changes. Message headers it is showing, so let's try to do this also. So we are going to coming to our listener method. So in listener method also we need to pass that at payload annotation, we need to do as it is suggesting at payload our context object, that is message. So we are annotating that here, yeah, parameter, message parameter with that payload, and we are adding headers also. Add headers, I think, add header, add headers, and then we are passing message headers object here. Let's see how it behaves after this change. Initially we are just trying whatever suggested on that, and then we will see whether it is actually what is actually needed or not. This message header is actually needed or not. Typo. So it should be, instead of handler, it should be header. So we are going to take the proper. And one more suggestion is, these IDs, modern days IDs, are very, very, very fast. And with the fastness, there comes a drawback also. Sometimes we need to be very, very cautious about taking our objects, because sometimes what may happen is JSON deserializer or JSON serializer are provided also by Faster XML as well as Spring Kafka. So if you import the other one, I mean by mistake also, if you import the JSON deserializer of Faster XML and deserializer of Faster XML, you would be spending hell lot of time identifying what the reason could be. Okay, so that's why we need to be extra cautious about checking our imports also. Before running the server, we should always check our imports, whether the packages are proper or things are proper or not, because IDE won't show issue any error there if the object doesn't expect any parameter, then it won't show any error also. So you may surprise, you may feel like, okay, there is no issue in while compilation, then how come this issue is coming while runtime? Okay, so it seems the header is having some issue. So we are going to remove we have removed the add header annotation. We just kept the add payload, and we are going to bounce the server with these configurations. And yeah, one more thing is, while trying again and again, we have our topic was corrupted, and so now we have started the server again. So we have created new topics for this. So now we are Kafka configured topic is message topic. So yeah, the message says message ID 8, like, share and subscribe, and we are also doing a promotion here, so please, we are targeting for 100k subs. We should target always for high, so that's why we are targeting 100k subs. So it's showing the message here, 100k subs. For watching, and don't forget to subscribe our channel, and press the bell icon, like, share and subscribe our work. And until next playground session, bye bye, have a nice life, enjoy.